and I said, you know, you must never think about art and only try and solve mechanical problems. And I believe that very firmly, but I think that I didn't quite say enough why that's true. And I think why it's true is that if you lock your conscious mind onto solving the problems that you face, this is the right angle, we only have 10 minutes to lunch, I only have so many lights, we've got to do this, but you know, all of that sort of day-to-day ordinary problem solving, it in a way allows unconscious material to come to the surface, or if not unconscious material, maybe too pompous a word, but at least unanalyzed material, which often is what the best stuff is. You know, you don't quite remember why or how you chose that angle of light or that angle of the camera, because you were rushing and through trying to solve. You know, you did it as far as you were concerned for very simple mechanical reasons, but often other more, I dread using those words, so I won't, but more unexamined reasons come to the surface later that you didn't notice then. And they would only come to the surface, and they would only be achieved by making your mind, it's almost a sort of Zen activity that you chant om, 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 om. In this case, you're chanting, oh my God, it's only 10 minutes to lunch. And doing that for with enough intensity, other material is allowed to come to the surface. I do truly believe that is a fact. Now, and the quality of the material that comes to the surface depends on the quality of the mind that's chanting, and that's not something that we can control. But what you can do is concentrate very hard on solving those problems, and trust that if you're not an utter idiot, other things may emerge. And I know of specific examples in my life when they did. Those will come up as we talk. I once directed a movie that it was only in post-production that I realized what I'd really been making the movie about. I had no idea. At the time, I was trying to talk to the actors, fighting with the actors, yelling and screaming, trying to get done on schedule and this and that. And then only later did I realize what the movie really turned out to be about. And it was the only movie I ever directed that was any good, because it had some actual emotional relevance to me that mercifully I didn't know. And it's obviously very good that I didn't know it, or that my conscious mind didn't know it until later on. It was really quite an amazing revelation in the editing room when I thought, oh my God, this is what I was doing this about. Well, that sort of thing on a much smaller level happens day after day after day, I'm quite sure. And you may not even, there may not be a moment when you see the dailies and you say, oh my God, that's what that shot was about. You know, you may not ever see it, but those shots, those angles, those bits of lighting do carry some kind of emotional message if you've done it right. And that may be emotional message of boredom and stupidity if you haven't done it right. But we have to sort of trust that eventually you won't get tired anymore if they're really boring and stupid. So I strongly advise and almost insist on what I was saying of the strictness of not worrying about art and all that crap, but knowing all the time that you are in a way tricking yourself into it. You know, I've used this example before, but I will again. In As You Like It, Touchstone, the clown, while trying to seduce a girl, says a shepherdess whose name I can't remember, says the truest poetry is the most feigning. And that's really, really true. There's a marvelous poem by W.H. Auden that takes that as its title, Truest Poetry is the Most Feigning. And it's all about tricking yourself into telling the truth by elaborate subterfuge. And the elaborate subterfuges mostly are, they may be to a certain extent the poet tricking the audience, but in fact it's mostly the poet tricking himself. And I'm not saying I'm a poet, by the way. I'm working cameraman, but the person doing the work, whatever it is, be it poetry, painting, movies, being a grip, loading magazines, whatever it is, often best succeeds by tricking him or herself into letting material come up that he didn't even know about. Mm-hmm.